your hands together. Shashank, Srivastava. Welcome, sir.
All right, good afternoon, everybody. Hope you are enjoying your affiliate Dreamin day today. And thank you for coming to understand how you can level up as a Salesforce developer. Right? So, I'm not good at lectures. So, I do a lot of interactive talking when I'm usually on the stage. I don't even like stages. I like being in the middle of you. So if you don't mind, can I have everybody come closer? Maybe people there can come here and stuff so that we may have a more intimate discussion about what we're going to do. So anybody who sits in the first 2 rows are going to get this because. Do you want these stickers?
Yeah.
So you have to sit in the first 2 rows. Okay. So whoever sits in the first 2 rows, going to get these stickers. First come, first serve. No, that is the first, this is the second. Some of you are already there. Don't worry. No, that is zero.
You can sit there.
Like the stickers? Are you going to use them? Where are you going to stick it on?
Laptop?
Anywhere else?
Mobiles?
Please, please. Oh, I'm going to leave it to your creativity. So, congratulations for the front pages. Back pages, don't worry. I'll try to be as loud as possible. Alright, okay. My name is Shashank Srivastava, and I'm a operations manager from Salesforce, part of the trailhead team, today we're going to talk about the topic from the device. Right, so level up as a Salesforce developer. So how many of you are already Salesforce developers here? How many of you have no idea what Salesforce is? You can raise your hand. It's okay. I'm not going to punish you. No punishments allowed. Okay, so how many of you are probably more than 5 years experience in Salesforce? How many of you are probably more than 3 years experience in Salesforce? How many of you are 1+? Less than one? Some of you, right? So how many of you are have only worked on Salesforce and not on any other technology? Right, so this is usually the case in our Salesforce ecosystem, and there are chances of you being probably siloed in your efforts to probably leveling up. So this is my small effort to make you understand about the whole landscape and what is there for you, and what's in store for you. Sorry, I have to stand here, I can't be interactive enough. Alright, 3 things between us and lunch. We have lunch at 1 o'clock, you all remember that, right? It's necessary, you worked hard enough in the first half, taking in all the knowledge. Just 3 things between us and dinner, us and lunch today. We're going to talk about the need for learning, and then how to level up, basically, the next level. How to level up, what are the next levels beyond that, right? So it's not rocket science that I'm going to talk about, but general stuff that you probably might miss out on when you're busy with your own life, right? So learning. So there's this thing called lifelong learning that I've come across. Basically means that learning does not stop at your childhood or at your college or in your initial on-the-job training or something. How many of you agree with this? Nobody agrees. How many of you disagree with this? Right, so learning is a continuous lifelong process, and there's no escaping that. You are always learning, no matter in your job or in your life, or it could be anything, right? In the technology that you're working on, in the technology that you already know, and what something might be changing there. Especially for a Salesforce developer, where we do 3 releases a year, keeping you very busy. Right, so every 4 months there's new release, there's a bunch of new features that come out. And even for developers, there's a bunch of new stuff that's come out, that comes out every release. Right, and you need to be constantly be aware of what's there, what's not there, in the releases and stuff. Right, so we don't have an option than to just keep learning. So learn. Right, so you know you have to learn, and you should know. Probably want to understand what and where and how you can learn to level up, right? So 4 important things as a Salesforce developer, someone who's developing on a Salesforce platform, right? Understand the business. Salesforce is a CRM platform, right? So CRM is basically customer relationship management, and Salesforce is in the business of making customers happy. So even the platform is basically built for making users of that of the application happen, right? And you need to know what the business wants from this application. The reason why the platform is so flexible is because there are various business needs that any businesses can have based on their work, their business style and everything, right? So you need to understand what business angle to what you're building. Then improve skills, right? Technical skills that you would usually need as a developer. Just knowing effects or visual force, just doing some trade packages, definitely not enough. We all agree with that, right? You need additional skills. You need to keep adding stuff to your skills and your tool belt and stuff, right? And embrace the community. The reason you're here, is you're already on your path of embracing the community. And I'll also give you some more pointers on what is in store for you in the community, and how you can give back to the community. Right? And most importantly, you need time to do all this, right? So how much time do you spend commuting to office in a day, on average? Anybody?
3 hours.
How much time do you sleep?
5 hours.
5 hours? That's it?
Yeah.
Are you on a diet or something? 7 hours, 10 hours, right? Various times, right? How much time do you stay in office?
10 hours.
9 to 10 hours. How much time is left in the day? Few, maybe 2 hours, 3 hours of your life. So it's important to find time for what you want to do. No matter what you want to learn or what you want to understand and stuff like that, it's not just Salesforce. Generally, for anything, you need to find time to be able to do whatever you want. Right? And we'll look at a little tip I have for you for finding time. Right? So, 3 important questions when you're trying to understand business. Who are you building for? Right? What is the business unit that is using your application or your Salesforce is mostly going to be sales people and sales organizations, or it could be service centers, or it could be internal HR applications, it could be payroll applications, it could be finance applications, it could be any application as well, right? So understand who you are building for, and then what you are building. Not as a developer, you might probably get lost saying that. I just need to write this effect class or create this visual force page or build this lightning component, right? But what is it actually doing? What is the user experience? You should have an understanding of that to understand the business better. And why you are building it? What is the actual use case that you are building it for? So even if you are just building like a small part of a large project, you should still know why to understand the importance of what you are building. And then move on to the how, because that's where your expertise comes in, right? As a Salesforce developer, to once you understand what you need to build, why you are building it, who you are building for, then you move on to how you are building it. What are you, what tech skills are you going to use to build these applications, right? So understanding business is the first foremost thing before you move on to figure out how to maybe become a better Salesforce developer, right? And then we have skills, right? So how many of you heard about the term full stack developer? Can anyone tell me what a full stack developer is? Yes, please. Pretty close. So full stack developer is basically someone who builds or codes all the
stack.
Sorry?
A developer who built a
complete applications. So in application development, we usually have these layers. We have a UI layer.
Yeah.
And then we have a server layer, maybe application layer, where we have the logic. And then there is a data layer. And then there are two other layers based on the infrastructure that we use. Right. So as in the normal world, we have separate UI developers, we have separate back-end developers, front-end, back-end, then there will be a database administrator and there will be a database team which does everything, right? But as a Salesforce developer, what would you call yourself? Do you call yourself a UI, a front-end developer? Or a back-end developer or a database developer? What do you choose out of these three? All, right? So let's just keep it straight. A Salesforce developer is a full stack developer. You own the whole stack, right? Can you guys hear me in the back? Okay. Alright, so Salesforce is a full stack developer. So we build UI, we write logic, we work with data, and we integrate systems as well. Right, so how many of you have built a visual force page? A lot of you, almost all of you. How many of you have written in the Apex controller, maybe? Apex class, Apex triggers. So when you use Apex triggers, what do you need an Apex trigger for? Can anyone tell me? Sorry? Apex trigger. Automate process. So when does a trigger get triggered in Salesforce? DML. What is the D in DML? Data. Right, so you're already working with data. Right? And you also integrate systems. How many of you work on integrations, like using APIs, stuff like that? Right? How many of you write code in other languages outside Salesforce? Some of you. How many of you are Java developers? Or at least work a little bit on Java? How many of you work at least a little bit on JavaScript? More than half of you, right? So just to keep it straight, we are full stack developers. There's no denying that. So four things I'm going to talk about when we're talking about improving skills. First is programming, right? So what do you program in Salesforce? What language? Apex, right? So Apex, how many of you consider yourself an expert on Apex? You think so? Have you used something called the platform cache that came out? Yeah, but you would consider yourself an expert. But this is a new thing that came out. So we are not aware of it. So always be in the lookout for what's coming, what's new, because it's very important. And the reason why Salesforce releases brand new feature is because a lot of people need it. So there is a lot of value that comes out of something like that. So it's always important to understand what's the latest. A lot of things coming up in Apex. How many of you heard about the Apex metadata API? Some of you. So now we'll be able to work with metadata directly from Apex classes. It's a small beginning, but still it's got it. A lot of things, those things coming up. And the other big thing, lightning experience. How many of you have worked on lightning experience? How many of you have never worked on lightning experience? Some of you. Right? How many of you have built at least one lightning component? Two? Three? Four? 15? Right, okay, so Lightning Experience is basically the way forward for Salesforce frontend. Being the full stack Salesforce developer, frontend is where Lightning fits into, right? So Lightning Experience is where all the new features are coming, all the new possibilities are coming out. For example, the dynamic Lightning pages, and it could be letting you create your own template, letting you edit pages right from inside the detail page. Lots of things, right? And Lightning Component Framework is the de facto framework to build applications. So don't shy away from Lightning Experience. You might probably be the greatest in most developer, but it's important to be good at developing for Lightning Experience. Right? So there's this really, really good trail called Develop for Lightning Experience on Trailhead. How many of you are Trailhead users? How many of you are not Trailhead users so that I can shoot you? There are no non-Trailhead users. So there is some amazing content on developing for Lightning Experience on Trailhead. There's a huge trail that we've dedicated for that. Feel free to go through that. Right? And most importantly, JavaScript. So let's be frank, let's be very honest. How many of you hate JavaScript? How many of you love JavaScript? How many of you don't have opinion? How many of you are forced to use JavaScript? I see the velocity at which the hand coming up is the highest for the last question. But important thing to understand is there will be various advancements in industry, and it's important to embrace the change, right? So a little bit more about the importance of JavaScript. JavaScript is kind of eating the world of development because of the design of the language and various places we can actually run it, right? So we spoke about the full stack, right? So if you have to build UI, what do you use? What programming language do you use? Sorry? Can you be a little more louder? I'm sure the lunch will be awesome. You have enough meat.
What kind of layout you are trying to make? If
it's
very complicated, then you have to go
to
HTML5.
Okay. But HTML5, I wouldn't call it a programming language. It's not a programming language. It's just tags.
Straightforward, and
you know,
thinking about the aspect is, so definitely everybody
will
go through the Apex for
user
page.
No, in general, not about Salesforce specifically. I'm talking about general, any application for the front end, what programming language do you use? What is the most popular programming language?
JavaScript.
Right, so for the back end, for the business application layer, what is the most popular language? C, Java, C++, C#, loads and loads of other languages, right? And there is third layer, right, database. What is the most popular programming language for working with database? SQL, DLSQL, to work with data, right? So if you wanted to be a full-stack developer, you should basically learn three different programming languages. Is that correct? Did I get the count right? 1, 2, 3. Right? JavaScript versus Java, Python, PHP, those kinds of things. Right? Versus ESQL or PSQL that comes with Microsoft SQL Server and stuff like that. Right? But can you maybe, what if we have like one language to rule them all? What if one language, with one language skill, we can build applications of various areas? Is that possible? Is it? It is already possible because JavaScript has already taken over the whole stack. So there are data stores which are JSON, JavaScript, or object notation based. The Node.js runs on the servers, so you can build application layers and business logic with JavaScript using Node.js. And then on the front end, there is a new JavaScript framework coming every 10 seconds. That's the word in the industry. Every 10 seconds, there's a new JavaScript framework that you can use. Most popular one being React and Angular and all these things. Right? So there is no escaping JavaScript, and there's reason why it's that popular, because of its ubiquity and approachability and flexibility, which can be run at various layers of the full stack. And Salesforce is also embracing JavaScript because it is basically the industry standard these days. And it is also creeping into the platform. Right? So my advice, learn JavaScript. Just do it. Very, very important for the future. I definitely feel that JavaScript is going to be in a lot more places than it is right now. And imagine if you know one language with, and the skills that you have at various levels of the stack. Right? So that is the advantage you get with us. Like I was telling you, not just front end and back end, there are mobile apps that can be built using JavaScript. Right? Anybody built mobile apps with JavaScript? Mobile apps? Yeah, you like, right? So it's already possible. You can build mobile apps. I might argue that hybrid apps are not that fast and stuff like that. But there are more new frameworks like React Native, which use JavaScript to build native kind of applications. And JavaScript is running on IoT, man. Come on. It's running on small Raspberry Pi devices as well. Right? So, keeping the technical barriers aside, you can still build applications on various parts of the stack. Right? So, if you want to learn JavaScript, JavaScript has the most resources online compared to any other language right now. At various levels, beginner, intermediate, advanced, interactive ones like Code Academy and Code Camp. I feel free to get some of them. And then if you're like a book person or if you want more advanced knowledge in JavaScript, this is an amazing book series called You Don't Know JS. Feel free to refer to that as well. Right? So that is JavaScript. That is about programming, what's new, and the other is about productivity, right? So there are various ways in which a developer can be productive. Right? Can you maybe give me three main productivity aspects for a developer? For a developer to be more productive, or to build applications faster, or to build applications easier. So can you think of any of the things that will help with you being a more productive developer?
Yeah.
Latest common IDEs. Okay, that's a very good point. What else?
We can as well from the IDE requirements. We can access the metadata within the IDE. So you don't have to go here and there and stuff. IDE would be
It's a very productive tool, definitely. What else? Blog. Documentation. Training. Learning. What else? Lot of other things, right? So Salesforce has been listening to feedback from developers. And we couldn't do a lot in the past, but now it's a different ball game altogether. Mm-hmm. How many of you have heard about Salesforce DX? How many of you have never heard about Salesforce DX? So Salesforce DX is a new initiative from Salesforce for a better developer experience, to give you more productive developer tools. For example, the new CLI, the new advanced IDE, the scratch-off environment that we can directly use. A lot of effort is going into making the environment source-driven instead of an org-driven. Instead of you going into an org and building it 100 or something 100 times. Just pull it outside into version control like GitHub, which is basically the industry standard and the way forward these days. We are letting you, helping you do that in a lot more easier way in Salesforce VS. Right? Make sure you explore this fantastic Dreamin module for getting started with Salesforce VS. It's not just much, it's a whole trail which teaches you what is Salesforce VS and how you build, how can you build application with Salesforce VS. And it also has an interesting tutorial on how to use Git and GitHub to promote control, how to use crash orgs, and how to sign up for a new Salesforce VX account and all of these things. Feel free to go through that, and I'm sure you're going to get a lot of value out of it. And be a more productive, more industry standard developer. Next important thing is I wanted to specifically talk about integrations on the platform. So, as being a Salesforce developer or being someone who has started off on Salesforce platform, I see a lot of people who don't go outside the platform. Right? You build your Apex class, you write your Apex classes, you build your Lightning components, visual post pages and stuff, and you kind of go deeper into that and forget about everything else. Right? But for an external person, if you say you are a Salesforce developer, they say, oh, I have this container integrated with Salesforce. You should be able to do that, right? You are a trusted Salesforce developer. Is it wrong for the other person to ask you for this? Isn't it fair? Right? So it's important to at least understand the integration landscape of Salesforce, how to integrate with, the platform, what are the various APIs, and what are the various ways in which you can integrate applications. And your good friend JavaScript is also going to help you here as well. You can actually build external applications using your existing JavaScript knowledge, using Node.js to integrate with Salesforce. You can build mobile apps, you can build web apps, which actually integrate with Salesforce very easily. Right, you can do it in other languages as well. You can use Java, you can use Python, but Node.js is a fantastic framework, and there are some really, really amazing open source modules that you can use to easily integrate with Salesforce. So when I built my first Node.js integration, it probably took me like a day or two to figure out how to use a module and build an individual application. If I didn't have those ready ML modules, probably would have taken me weeks or months to get it. There's already so much contribution happening in that direction. You can just use the existing resources that are available, open source projects, tutorials, blogs, and stuff which help you with these kinds of things. Right? And don't forget to try out the platform events feature that has come out. This is basically an event-driven architecture of integrated with applications. It's basically a more scalable and suits large data volumes for integrated applications. I'm not going to take a lot of time explaining what it is about, because again, there's a really good training module to understand that. So whatever resources I'm talking to you today, I'm going to share it through a blog for which I'm going to give the link now. Feel free to refer to all these resources when you have time after you leave this session. Okay, so don't worry about the links and stuff. I'm going to provide it to you anyway. Okay, last but not least, actually the most important is the innovation that you can do as a developer. Right? Understand what's the latest trend in the industry. Any guess what's the current trend in the industry, the current buzzword? AI, right? What else? Intelligence, what else? Just because you saw it there? IoT is also big because of the computing power we have, of the advanced technology that we have these days. Right? IoT, AI, mobility, Hopefully it'll be worse because even now AI will have taken over. At least understand what are these technologies about, how to maybe probably what is the how to get started on these kinds of technologies so that we can understand how we can integrate them into your Salesforce application. Because the reason why technology becomes popular is that it has so much value that people have invested in building something like that. And imagine if you can use that in your application, then how much more value will your application have, right? So specifically from Salesforce, at least as Salesforce developer, one innovation I really want you to look into is Einstein. Have you heard about Einstein? Just in case?
Yes.
Yeah? So Einstein, what's Einstein doing? So that is data analysis. Right? Where is the intelligence in that? So that is a general term for data science and stuff. So Salesforce Einstein is basically Salesforce. It's not a single product or a feature. It's basically Salesforce effort to provide more AI and machine learning and deep learning features in our suite of clouds and applications. And also inside the platform, Salesforce provides started providing something called the Einstein Platform Services, which are basically readily available services that are available through a simple REST API for you to directly use. Right? So for example, we have language. Right, so Einstein sentiment and Einstein intent are readily available REST resources, REST API endpoints that you can directly use to get intelligent insights automatically. For example, you just send a particular sentence to the service and it will tell you what category of a question that is. Right, so when you read that, you would know that because you are intelligent. But this system has that intelligence and it can figure out without any human intervention about what someone is talking about. For example, if you want to probably go through the social feeds mentioning your organization or your customer or your partner and understand the sentiment or at least the positivity or negativity about your entity on the social feeds. Right, you can just rely on the Einstein sentiment service to let you just tell you whether it's a positive thing or a negative thing. What is the current janta thinking about you and stuff like that? Right, and then we have vision, Einstein vision, which is basically computer vision. Once you can train it so that it will understand what's there in an image. Just give it an image and it will understand. So imagine. When there's someone like a field service technician who goes to repair a very old model legacy refrigerator and he just wants to understand which model is it before he can repair it, right? So how does he know which model it is? What if he knows by just looking at it which model? It's a lot easier that way, right? So if you are an experienced technician, you would know that this is this model bridge and this needs this kind of servicing, right? But what if you are a new guy and all you have is just one new refrigerator set up, you can't call your senior technician to find out, right? So what if you can just take a pick of it and find out which model it is, right? So that is what that is just one of the thousands of possibilities of using computer vision for these kinds of things. And Einstein Vision provides you this service. Image classification and object detection, which you can directly use in your applications, right? And then Einstein Analytics, we will not talk a lot about that because it's a fairly new offering. It's basically intelligence embedded into analytics systems, right? Let's not talk too much about that today. Okay, no denying AI is the in thing these days. It's important to at least understand the landscape of artificial intelligence and machine learning and deep learning and all this. Right, so there is a really good trail again on Trailhead to let you understand what are the offerings of Salesforce next time, what is it in it for a developer or a business user to use Einstein, right? So, and if you want to go a little deeper, you want to, you probably don't have to create your own algorithms and stuff, but if you want to understand how the science of machine learning and stuff, there is this really, really popular course from Stanford University provided for free online on this website called Coursera. How many of you heard about Coursera? It's a popular learning website, right? So there's this, just search machine learning and look for the Stanford University one. There's this professor and Andrew NG, who is a very popular person in the AI community. It is his course, and trust me, it's pretty good. Even if you have never heard about artificial intelligence, you will still get a good understanding of it. All you need to do is just remind yourself of the little mathematics you learned at school. You've already learned that, don't worry, it won't teach you new trigonometry and stuff. Don't get too stressed. Okay, and there are already existing Apex wrappers and other language wrappers that are available through open source projects for you to try using these APIs directly. Right, you can, if you are familiar with or comfortable with using REST APIs, you can use it yourself. Or there are also existing wrappers that existing Apex wrappers can directly use inside your application. Or once you've learned enough JavaScript, you can write your own WordPress applications which interact with these APIs and stuff. So feel free to play around to do all that. And last but not the least, the community. So I told you about all these skills and stuff. There are various places you can go to where you can learn and stuff. Right? But the community, Salesforce community is kind of unique in the way, the amount of activity that we have, the amount of participation we have. I just wanted to highlight a few channels that we have in the community and what you can do as part of it. First of all, find a mentor. Find someone who is well known in the community or who is known for his mentorship or leadership skills, and just ask him to help you out. So that is one way of doing it. The various online channels for the community. We have Twitter. How many of you don't have a Twitter account? Get one. Okay. Get a Twitter account, make sure you at least follow this hashtag. This is a very valuable hashtag AskForce. Lot of questions being asked and lot of answers being given for these kinds of things. Very valuable learning resource. And of course we have the success community, we have the developer forums where you can post your questions or just search for questions asked by others and get answers. And the Salesforce Stack Exchange, which is well known for the kind of people who answer there. Very reputed Salesforce developers, very high skilled developers, which we answer at the Stack Exchange. Don't miss that. And of course, there's very good blogs coming out, very, very interesting blogs coming out with every related feature. And make sure you follow a few bloggers, a few popular bloggers at least, to learn from them what they have learned. They are sharing their knowledge, feel free to use that, right? And then we have events, direct on-site events. We have developer group meetups, user group meetups. How many of you are part of a developer group? How many of you are from Noida? How many of you are not from Noida? Right, so find the nearest developer group, join it, go to the next meetup, and I'm sure you will like it, and you'll just keep going every time. There's a lot of people sharing their knowledge and networking, and a lot of information exchange keeps happening in these groups. Feel free to join them, and of course, community events like this one, you're already doing your part in this. Kudos to all of you for making time on Dashera specifically to come to this event for knowledge. A lot of applause for that. Okay, and Salesforce also does a lot of events, not in India yet, but we have been posting many events that keeps happening every year. Talk to your boss, maybe he might get convinced. explore kind of things, design yours, to create for all the engineers. Right, this is a big matrix of activity. Don't get overwhelmed. I'm going to share this little a few tips on what you can do inside the community. There are two different categories. In all the channels, you can either utilize it or contribute to it. There are two ways for you to get community. Right, but they are both connected. If you don't contribute, you can't utilize it. If you only keep utilizing, you won't be able to contribute, and then you can't utilize it. Right, it's a cycle, contribute, utilize. What you can do in each of these sections to do your little part for the community or use the community. Right? So, a little bit of highlighting, just like you would find a mentor, if you think you have good mentorship skills, start mentoring people who want to learn. Right? That is one example. And then, instead of posting questions, start answering questions. Going to meetups, start arranging meetups. We should give a round of applause to the organizers of India Dreaming as well, because they work so hard to put you all in one place and let you learn. Right? So these kind of things have only happened with contributions, self-help contributions in the community. And it will only help you because you are the ones who can utilize it. Right? So that was about community. And I was telling you about time, right? So, if you really have the will, you will definitely make time. And if you find it a little difficult to find time, all I say is find 1 hour a day, or maybe half an hour a day. Maybe during commute, most of you told me you spend 3 hours in commute. Right? In case you're not driving, if you're not in a driving seat, try to spend that on something like maybe browsing the online channels, try answering a few questions, or try reading a blog, or reading watching a video, or something like that. Geo4G is pretty easy, right? Right? Okay, and morning, evening, doing work, don't tell your bosses, right? Just 1 hour is what we need. It's all we need, that, basically. There are 365 hours in an hour in which you can complete a machine learning course, an advanced JavaScript course, super advanced IoT course, and all of these things in 1 year. Trust me, if you use the 365 hours properly, right? And of course, not just to use it, the developer. Next level, once you have leveled up, you always look out to the next level, right? And this next level will be different for different individuals. So I'm not going to give you specific tips on next levels. But as a Salesforce developer, for example, if you want better opportunities, certifications is one way of looking at it. If you're interested, maybe become like a technical architect or something. The certification path, which pays you with this one certificate where there's a lot of guidance. Now there's a proper path of becoming technical. You don't have to complete the certificate also, just because the resources that are needed for this certification, they're all available to you. You can typically just learn from that. That's all it takes, right? And there's this, I would say three things, the Dreamin framework that we follow. Learn, connect, but to go to the next level, repeat. Right, learn, connect, repeat, that should be our mantra for the rest of our Salesforce career. And that, thank you so much. And this is the link to the blog I was telling you. Feel free to note it down or take a pic or something. Just want to remember it. It's bit.ly, the popular link shortener, /levelup, name of the session, India Dreamin. bit.ly/levelupindiadreamin. The blog is not up yet, but it's going to be up by tonight or tomorrow. Note down the URL and get back. You can come back here to look at all the resources, the links and stuff. Thank you so much.